Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Chris back here. Just want to make it quick. This will be my, I guess, second mail call video. I got quite a pretty good stack of records here shipped from New York. I found someone selling some stuff online and happened to make a really good deal for all these records. So I bought quite a few and they shipped them out for me. So I kind of opened them up a little bit, but as you can see, that's a healthy stack. To save some time, I kind of took them out of the box, but here we go. Packaged pretty crazy. Oh, sorry, taking forever here to open, but hope everyone's week is going good. I'm getting ready to head to work as usual on my Wednesday night. Just kind of set those down there like that. I can already see one that I'm pretty excited about. Oh, I should have opened it before. So these were all bought for, I think there's like 30 something in here, but okay, so first one in here is the Beatles White Album. Pretty good serial number on that. The cover's a little roached, but for the price I got this, the vinyl's still pretty good. For the price I got it for, I had to get it. This number right here, I have the white reissue, so I do not have a regular white album, so that's kind of nice. The normal press, I guess you could say. Everyone knows what's on that one. Next one, The Clash Combat Rock. It's a fantastic album. This is only my second Clash album. It's on the Epic. Fantastic shape. Obviously Rock the Casbah. It's gonna be really good out. Actually, I might put that on next. Next one, we have Fleetwood Mac. This is a Kiln House. I think it's a gatefold. Kind of a cool little sunset there. And that one is on the Reprise Brown. I'm not going to go too in-depth with these. It would take probably a long time, but next one, we have a Kinks Greatest Hits, Dead End Street. Once again, the jacket's a little kind of roached, but I think I can work with this one. And that's what I kind of got it for, six previously unreleased tracks. The unreleased tracks on here are Misty Water, Pictures in the Sand, Spotty Grotty Anna, Groovy Movies, Time Will Tell, and Rosemary Rose. So, be a good listen. This one was kind of cool. I did not have a copy of this. I was kind of looking forward to it, but the Heavy Metal soundtrack. I'm sure a lot of you remember this animated movie. Kind of Japanimation. Pretty cool gatefold there. Black Sabbath, Foolish Occult, Cheap Trick, and then pretty cool label with the says Heavy Metal on it. It's on Asylum Records. It's got Devo, Grand Funk, Journey, Stevie Nicks. Good stuff. I'm gonna save that one for last because that's one I was really excited about. And this one, got another copy of Revolver. my favorite Beatles album. And I can't remember which. Capitol Rainbow. Next one, LTG Exchange, Susie Heartbreaker. This one's on RCA, yep, RCA. Next one, very happy to add this to my collection of albums by them, U2, Rattle and Hum. Good track listing on this one, nice gatefold, the band there. And there's the label. Helter Skelter, Silver and Gold, great album. Next one, I had not heard this album, but it looked kind of interesting, so I got it. UK, Night After Night. Collector's Edition label. Huh. I don't know if I've seen that one. I've seen some of the collector's labels on 45, but not on albums usually. Alright, that's a pretty good one. The McCoys, You Make Me Feel So Good. This is on the, Bang label. I love that label. It's one of my favorites. Every time I find a 45 with a Bang label, I always gotta get it. Alright, next one. The Doors 13. Pretty sure that's just a compilation. But sometimes, you know, you just wanna throw on a comp when people are over. On the Elektra. Has all their hits. Next one, another greatest hits, Bob Dylan. I have a couple copies of this now, but I think I got this because it was a upgrade for me. Yeah, it's a clean copy on Capitol. All right, next we have the New Colony 6, Revelations. Another album I haven't really listened to a whole lot of, but I have heard the I Will Always Think About You song. It's on the Red Mercury label. It's kind of cool. I don't know if I have any of the on the Red Mercury. I have Black and some of their later ones, but really looking forward to spinning that one. Next one, The American Breed, Bend Me, Shape Me. On the ACTA label. Not a real common one that I see a lot down here anyway. Alright. Next, we got U2 War. Oh, even had the, you see it was a near mint copy. Has my favorite U2 song on here, Sunday Bloody Sunday. Add to the collection on Island. Alright, next we got some hard rock for all you hard rock fans out there. Saxon. It says Innocence Is No Excuse. Got the nice picture of the band there. That's on Capitol. Still in the shrink too. Like I said, for the prices, I had to pick all these up. It was a no-brainer. This one, I believe, yep, Plastic Ono Band. This is Live Piece in Toronto. is my first Plastic Ono Band album. It's on Apple. Next one, Psychedelic Furs, Talk Talk Talk. This one has Pretty in Pink on it. That's one of the reasons I got it. Still in the shrink and the hype sticker. I think this one is on Capitol. Yep, Capitol. This is one of the ones that I was really excited about in here. The second, probably, main one that I was excited about. This is Patti Smith Horses. Great, great album. I had a copy, but I don't know what happened to it. It's on the Arista label. And this one's just in fantastic shape. I think my other one was kind of beat, so I sold it, I think. So it's nice to get that back in the collection. Next one, another cool band, The Pogues. This is Rum, Sodomy, and The Lash. Kind of a crazy cover there. It looks like old, like Pirates Day, you know, like where someone's, like they all got sick on the ship or something like that, but pretty neat. That's on the Stiff Records. I've not given that album a listen yet, so I'm excited about that. This is a Steve Miller Band that I did not have. This is a Steve Miller Band, Recall the Beginning, Journey from Eden. Did not have this one. There's a gatefold. Pretty cool. On Capitol, the Green Capitol. Oh, thought the music was stopped, but it's still going. This one, I think, is one of the coolest covers around. One of the reasons I bought it, plus it's a great album. Sly and the Family Stone. There's a riot going on, I think is the name of it. Yep. It's a compilation of the band, some photographs. Gatefold. Looks like they're opening. Not sure where that is in concert, but it looks pretty cool. It's got the original inner sleeve. Looks like a newspaper. That's on Epic. This album, once I get it cleaned up, will definitely be going on my shelf. I just love that cover. Anything with the US flag, I'm just super excited about all the time. All right, next. I can't remember what this one was. Oh, that's right. It's The Members, Solitary Confinement. This is actually, I believe, a single. There's the 12-inch single on Virgin. Still in the shrink. I almost forgot what it's been a couple weeks since I bought these. I finally shipped them down, so I can't remember what I really bought. Oh, this was a cool one. Max Webster, Hangover. Got the lyric sheet, and that is on the Mercury label, the later Mercury. Like I said, I haven't listened to a lot of these yet, so. Next one, Gentle Giant, Pretentious. That one is on the Vertigo, no swirl, unfortunately. This one is a gatefold as well. 2 LP album. Eddie and the Hot Rods, Life on the Line. Kind of a crazy cover there, and trying to hang himself. Oh. This one looks like it's a gatefold. On the island as well. Alright, we got Savoy Brown, Raw Sienna. This would be my fourth album by them now. Gatefold. Really just started to crack the surface of Savoy Brown. I'm really starting to like the music, so I'm just trying to pick up as much as I can. It's on Parrot, which is a subsidiary of London Records, I believe. That price tag is not what I paid for, by the way. Or any of it. Next one, we got another from the McCoys, Human Ball. It's on Mercury again as well. Different Mercury label, the earlier one. Alright. Got about six more, I think. Another one from, actually, it's my first one, Proko Harum. This is Broken Barricades. Kind of a cool cover, too. It's got a gatefold that, you know, that covers the heads. Pretty neat. Oh, I think it opens from the inside. It's on A&M. Got a Peter Gabriel. Sorry. I think this is a... Is this the self-title? I think so. It's on Echo. Got the original inner sleeve. Try not to damage that when I put it back in here. Did not have any Peter Gabriel. I had been wanting to get some for quite a while. Another Peter Gabriel there. On Mercury. And you can see that I just kept the trend rolling. Oh, that one's on Atlantic. And what do you think's next? That's right, Peter Gabriel. Real excited to dive into these. This one's still on the shrink with the hype. On Geffen. And the last one, I forgot I got this one. Another hard rock album from Saxon. Strong Arm of the Law. What's going on? Carefree. Never really seen that one. So, leads us down to the last album I got from this seller. And I was just really excited about it. I've been wanting it for a long time, but I just can't pay the money that people are wanting. This cover needs some work, but maybe I can find a cover one day. This is the Ronettes featuring Veronica. Got Breaking Up on here. And obviously the main reason I got it for was Be My Baby. Phil Spector. Still in great shape here. As you can see, the cover is starting to come apart there, but this is a pretty expensive album. So I got it at a fantastic price. I mean, really fantastic price, so I was really happy to pick that up. You know, kind of put Phil Spector in the Wall of Sound on the map. This is on Philly's Records. I did not have anything on that label either. Kind of put them on the map, and obviously started this trend of making just fantastic albums. And then I did want to show a couple more. Brian over at Shamrock and Records he didn't really show it. He was listening to it in the background, and I just had to pick it up. Stand By Me soundtrack. So thanks, Brian, for making me spend some more money. And what we were just listening to was Charlie Mingus, Black Saint and the Sinner Lady. That's on Impulse. And the last thing I just wanted to show, it was my birthday last week, and my kids got me this pretty cool card. So I thought I'd show it. So can I get a little bit more party in here? And you open it up. That's pretty cool, I thought. So that definitely, they did a good job on getting my card this year. So I was happy about that. So anyways, that's my mail call. Pretty big one this time. So hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.